And speaking of powerful photographs, Dr. Jeff Gusky is not only an ER physician, he's also an incredible photographer. His work is on display in the Smithsonian.
He also has a unique perspective on how the pandemic of the Spanish-American War in 1898 eased racial tension, and if done right, could affect our response to the current coronavirus pandemic. Good morning. Thanks for being with us.
Good morning. It's great to be with you.
So,
this is a time of hope.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
This is a time of hope.
Well,
great hope.
It's nice to have your perspective. You're someone who's a doctor and someone who studies history. Tell us how all this comes together for you.
I found a secret hidden for 100 years that changes the way we see race in America and the way we see ourselves, and it's a Chicago story. I stumbled onto the only trace of a black combat unit in World War I, and it turns out they weren't just any unit. They were the only all-African-American unit in the entire U.S. military. And 102 years ago, when they fought so patriotically for America, that unit had already been together for 49 years. So it's a story of African-American political power and self-determination that we don't know about. And here's the connection to Corona. 20 years before World War I, they became the first all-African-American unit in the history of America to deploy in combat. Why? Because they went to the Illinois governor and volunteered in the midst of a frightening pandemic when soldiers were dropping like flies to go to war. And what's amazing is that the African American surgeons that ran the field hospitals understood disease. And the hospitals were so clean that the disease rate plummeted. They came back as heroes. And it's a Jackie Robinson moment about which no one knows.
But doctor, did people at that time, did they know that story? Did that story get out in the newspapers?
Yes, they did. The colonel who was the highest, he was the first black colonel in the U.S. military, named Colonel John R. Marshall, was invited to the White House by President McKinley. He was against this move. It was called the Experiment in Color. But in Illinois, Abraham Lincoln's vision still mattered, and the governor had the courage to send this unit to war that so devotedly wanted to fight for our country. They got America. They loved America unconditionally, knowing it was totally imperfect. And so they come back as heroes. The colonel, born a slave, the illegitimate grandson of the longest sitting U.S. Supreme Court Chief Justice in history, even through today, goes to the White House. His grandfather inaugurated Thomas Jefferson.
Wow.
It's amazing.
It's an amazing story. We have no idea how it changes the narrative on race in America. And here's another one that will blow your audience's mind, and it's a story of pride for Illinois. On the last day, the last hour, the last minute of World War I, the last Americans fighting were the Black Devils, the only all-African-American unit in the entire U.S. military, led by the highest-ranking black officer in the Army, whose grandfather was a personal friend of Abraham Lincoln and a pallbearer at his funeral.
Wow, this is it's the stuff of a movie. And how are we not hearing about this? Did you say you found some type of a trace,
an artifact
in France?
Absolutely. Underground, in the middle of nowhere, beneath a farm field, right now exists the only trace of a black combat unit, and it was this unit from Chicago. They left their mark. It was the underground command post of this unit that the Germans called the Black Devils because of their fierceness in combat. They were visionaries, not victims. They were leaders, and they understood America when America didn't get them. And it turns out they were an all-volunteer, all-black militia formed just after the Civil War by returning African-American patriots when there weren't many African-Americans in Illinois. And they became the torchbearers of Abraham Lincoln's vision of freedom for all of us. And we don't know the story. They were nearly 50 years old by the time of World War I. There were so many firsts. It's almost like a mystical bridge across 100 years telling us that we got race wrong in America. And this is an opportunity to get race right. And in crisis, you know, we see differently. As an ER doc, I see moments when complete strangers save the lives of complete strangers. And it doesn't matter what their skin color is. When someone has just saved your life, you don't see race, you see human. Mm. And what's so cool about this story is that these are African-American patriots that saved America and gave America hope at the time of a frightening pandemic that was much scarier than what we're facing now.
Wow.
And they show us all where we find hope and courage in facing a threat fearlessly with confidence and knowing and believing in ourselves as Americans.
Wow. Well, that is an amazing story, and you are an amazing storyteller. I look forward to hearing more about this story down
the
road.
Thank you. It's an honor.